Eating healthy and exercise has become a very important focus in families as our country faces the obesity epidemic. With kids, getting plenty of exercise is important, and that exercise should also include strength training. Believe it or not, back with us is the fitness nomad, John Ashworth. Hey, great to see you again.
Good to see you.
I was giving you a tough time. I was like, we give you a little break and you grow the beard out.
That's right, that's right. Little rogue style.
It's good to see you. So we're talking strength training today, and let's start with why it's important to bring this into a child's routine.
Well, there's for a long time, the myth has been strength training bad for kids, that it's not good for their growth plates and their bones, and as a result, stunts their growth.
You know, their weight or anything.
No, but for a long time, it was just a myth, because when we put kids in the workforce in the industrial age, we found that that stunted their growth, and that they were doing a lot of heavy work, heavy lifting in those jobs. So for a long time, we have felt like strength training was probably bad for them, too.
Interesting.
But not the case. For kids 7 to 12 years old, it's one of the best things you can do.
There was a study done recently on this. Talk
right.
about that.
So what they did is it wasn't one study. It was a review. So the researchers went into the literature and basically pulled down every study that's out there on strength training in kids, and what they found was that especially for kids age 7 to 12 years old, they're actually able to build strength and it doesn't harm them at all if done properly.
So parents shouldn't be concerned?
Parents shouldn't be concerned. What they should be concerned about is getting them involved in a program that is taught by someone who knows what they're doing, that program is fun and exciting and leaves the kids feeling like, you know, they want to come back.
Because how often do kids have an opportunity to do strength training? I know my daughter the other night was running. I have just the little dumbbells at home, and
right.
she was, you know, doing. She loves doing them.
Right.
Not consistently, right. but she thinks it's fun.
Yeah. Unfortunately, kids don't have a lot of opportunity to do that, especially if they're not involved in sports. And even when they are, they're sedentary so mm-hmm. much of the time that you take them from the couch and you put them out on the athletic field, and it really increases the chance for injury. So some form of regular strength training, it doesn't even have to be with weights. It could be a fun with medicine balls, whatever you want to do, having them carry heavy things across a field, just making it fun, keeping it interesting, but it is really, really important.
Okay, so some examples. I mean, you just gave a few.
Yeah, so some examples would be a boot camp style class where we did a boot camp class at the park in Westmoreland mm-hmm. Park one year as a promotion for the boot camp, and the kids came out, they participated with their parents. We were running, a lot of jumping, a lot of push-ups and burpees, and making games that everybody's playing at one time.
So isometric like exercise, I mean using your own body weight.
Plyometric body weight type exercises.
Sorry, I got that
Absolutely.
Wrong.
Absolutely, that's all right. But I think it's still important for kids to get into the gym and really
gyms
reinforce.
Most gyms won't allow kids to come in.
Right, so the good news is that my gym will, and I have a little pilot program coming. So, but yeah, that is one of the problems.
Yeah, so something to look at what you might be able to do at home with the bands or whatever, or
right.
look at gyms that will allow
right.
your kids to come in.
Right.
Because most would like to try it. So.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, John, great to see you back in
Good
again.
To see you,
We're
going
to have a link to John's blog at our web channel, NBC15.com. Just click on news links. We'll see you again in a few weeks. Have